At Greenwood Public School, Hannah, a graduate teacher, sets achievable challenges for her students. To consolidate their understanding of conservable energy, she engages students in higher order problem solving tasks centered around an ICT tool.
All right, so I really want you guys to just think about the conversion between kinetic and potential energy. Just have a think, because I'm actually going to give you a task, which, because I know most of you are actually in the extension group, so it's actually quite difficult. Really problem solving. I'm going to get you guys to work in pairs. You're going to have a dependent variable. So do you guys kind of remember what that means? Dependent?
Variable.
Hands up. Yep.
The variable that you measure.
That you measure. Okay, good. Independent? Hands up. Variable that you change. Okay, guys, so I'm going to give you the dependent variable. The dependent variable is going to be the amount of energy the skater has. So I want you to change the amount of energy the skater has by doing something on here. Okay, you two girls, just really quickly, what did you do?
We also used friction. We did it with no friction,
okay.
Low friction, medium friction, high, and very high. And we found that when there's no friction, it would just keep going. Like, it wouldn't
yep.
stop. And with the medium one, it would only go halfway, and then it would take like a minute to stop. And then with high friction, it would only go up the ramp and then stop as soon as it reached the bottom.
Excellent. Perfect. You guys had an interesting one. What was yours?
Ours had two loops. We changed the skater, so how much it weighed.
Okay, so with the different skaters, so obviously you got the ladybugs really light, you got the bulldog, which is really heavy. So they actually changed the skater. I can't remember anybody else choosing to do that one, but it's a really good one.
Yeah,
so yeah, keep going.
But we kept the gravity the same, and we found
excellent.
That like, if the object is heavier, it would use more energy.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And did they all end up going, because these guys had a really good ramp, they actually had two, kind of like a roller coaster, they had two loops. Did all of them actually get through the
yeah,
loop?
Yeah, they all got through.
Okay, so even the ladybug was heavy enough
yeah.
to actually...
And they both took the same time to, like, do
okay.
the thing.
Took the same time,
yeah,
but
yeah.
the energy was different.
Different, yeah.
Okay, that's interesting.
Why is it important to set challenging but achievable learning goals for students? How do you balance challenge with achievable learning outcomes?